coming to U.S. theaters for the very first time on November 3rd, Godzilla Day. The 2002 feature, Godzilla vs. Mechagodzilla. Now, this is not the original 1974 film. This is the updated version. We've got a new Godzilla emerging, and the Japanese self-defense forces build a cyborg using the body of the original Godzilla, whose restless soul inhabits the machine. The film will screen through Fathom Events in 450 theaters in the U.S. in the original Japanese with English subtitles. Tickets are now on sale. We've got a link to the trailer in our notes. And we've got casting news for the new Godzilla show. Anders Holm is joining the cast of the Godzilla and Titan series over at Apple. He'll have a recurring role. Character details are under wrap, of course. The official description of the series, quote, "Following the thunderous battle between Godzilla and the Titans that leveled San Francisco and the shocking new reality that monsters are real," short sentences are okay too, you know, "the untitled series will explore one family's journey to uncover its buried secrets and a legacy linking them to the secret organization known as Monarch." The series was co-created by Chris Black and Matt Fraction. Black is serving as showrunner. And I guess, Tim, that's kind of a thing that we're going to look for monsters and kaiju, because you've got a story over there as well, Godzilla related, do you know?
There's a lot of Godzilla news coming out, apparently. This one is something that you can actually watch live if you want, because it's a live event. Hi folks, welcome to the weekend, and just like Jason said, I got a lot of horror news today as well. Excuse me. And hopefully we have audio. I just thought I'd glance over at the chat to make sure it's that kind of morning. All right. Yeah, so Godzilla news. Masters of Horror from Scream Factory, November 3rd, of course, Godzilla Day. John Carpenter has teamed up with the folks over at Scream Factory to talk about to help screen and discuss his four favorite kaiju films. And then we got Godzilla, the uncut Japanese original, Rodan, Ghidorah, the three-headed monster, and the War of the Gargantuas. And Carpenter's going to be making appearances throughout these live streaming events. So November 3rd is Godzilla, the uncut Japanese original. November 4th is Rodan. November 5th, Ghidorah, the three-headed monster. And those are all on watch parties over on Scream Factory TV. And then November 6th, we've got the War of the Gargantuas, which is the watch party is going to be happening over on Toku Shout's Twitch. Excuse me, Kat, you're in the way. Sorry. So, yeah, something definitely cool to check out. These are all fantastic kaiju films. If you've not seen them, this is a great opportunity to do that. And, of course, to get a little insight from Carpenter, who is, you know, something of a name in horror, just a little bit. And well wishes to Emma Caulfield, who has announced that she has been suffering from multiple sclerosis for over a decade. Now, of course, a lot of fans know her from Buffy the Vampire Slayer and WandaVision and other shows. She continues to work and is not letting her diagnosis and illness get in the way as much as possible. But it is a ongoing condition and something that she is dealing with. Now, she has not been discussing this, but she just recently rebuilt it. But her father has MS, and they have been something that she's been familiar with for her life. And she felt like she just wasn't being honest without revealing it. So she has done that. She says she's feeling okay right now, but she's going to keep going. So certainly we wish her nothing but the best. She's if you're a genre fan, she's been a part of the genre world for a long time. And certainly we hope that she continues to maintain a level as much as one can when dealing with multiple sclerosis. And just a little moment here before I dive into the rest of the news. This is a great time for horror fans right now. There are over a dozen new or returning projects that have a lot of fan love that are out there right now. We've got the new Hellraiser, which just came out. We've got the star of that, Odessa Zion, is in a new film called The Inhabitant, which comes out on October 7th, which also stars Dumma Maruni. Fiona DeRiff has a new film coming out on October 7th called Don't Look at the Demon, where she's been involved with Chucky and has got her own large growing fan base. Trick or Treat, the huge Halloween fan favorite, is finally getting a theatrical release. The film, when they originally came out, the distributors had no idea what to do with it. They weren't sure it was going to do anything, so it went straight to video, built a huge fan base. It's finally coming to theaters this Halloween season. They Crawl Beneath, which is a practical effect heavy monster movie, just came out on digital Blu-ray and DVD. Mr. Harrigan's Phone, another Stephen King film, just came out. Terrifier 2 just came out. Shudder has got a new film called Deadstream, which is a horror comedy, which has gotten a lot of previous buzz. And then A Significant Other is about its way, which is a alien horror relationship movie, which is a thing. And then for kids, you've got a Scooby-Doo thing coming out here. So this is a great time. If you there's an abundance of riches here, a lot of which is stuff that as folks have been waiting for a long time, has been getting good reviews, and it's a great time to be a horror fan. So if you've not checked out some of these things, if you've never had the opportunity to see something like Trick or Treat in the theaters, this is a great time to be a horror fan.
Before you go on, let me ask a clarification question if I can.
Sure.
Because you mentioned the Scooby-Doo thing. You're talking about a different Scooby-Doo thing, not
right.
The Velma.
This is not
HBO
the cancel
Max.
One. This is Trick or Treat Scooby-Doo.
Okay.
Which is a thing which actually has not been canceled. So this is a thing that's out there. This is, you know, so
because we got a trailer for Velma for HBO Max, which is the Mindy Kaling.
Right. It's a separate project.
Okay. I just wanted to just clarify that.
Yes, and that's fair. But I mean, because this is that's all stuff that's either canceled or on its way. This is something that I think I don't actually have the date down here. And of course, I left out Werewolf by Night. So you've got some Marvel horror as well. I mean, there's just all kinds of stuff here. But yeah, just really cool opportunity if you're a horror fan to just soak up a lot of really fun stuff. And some other good news here was some projects that had been either in limbo, derailed, or just probably never going to happen for lots of reasons. Some of them are back on track, and we'll see how long this lasts. But Five Nights at Freddy's has actually found a director. This apparently is finally going to be a thing that's happening. Now, we've heard a little bit of rumor about this from the folks over at Blumhouse before, but they picked up a director in Emma Tammi, who made her debut with horror in a 2018 film called Western called The Wind. Now, she is going to direct the film. They're looking at early 2023 for start of principal photography. And the folks over at Jim Henson's Creature Shop are working on our animatronic baddies here. So that's a thing that actually seems to be happening. A long time, very much in limbo. And Spawn has found a new set of writers. Now, of course, this reboot has long been in various states of it's happening, it's not happening, we're not knowing what's going on. Todd McFarlane, who had been at one point writing it and directing it, has actually got the Joker's Scott Silver, Falcon and the Winter Soldier's Malcolm Spellman, and Matt Mixon are teamed up to write the new script. He's looking at maybe having somebody else take over directing because the opportunity to get a good director in the place. I mean, McFarlane would love to do it, but you know, having someone who is a really fantastic, known director is also a possibility. He said, you've got an A-list actor, A-list producers, A-list writers. Then do you want to shoot for A-list directors, A-list cinematographers? The answer is, of course, let's keep the momentum going. So basically, he reached out to these folks and said, hey, guys, would you like to take a crack at this? And they said, yes. And he was like, great, fantastic. So we'll see. We've been burned before with Spawn. We'll have to see what happens. And Robert Eggers' Nosferatu which we reported on, I think, a couple of months ago, that was had gone derailed for various reasons, including COVID-19 issues. It is apparently moving forward again with Bill Skarsgård and Lily Rose Depp in talks to star in it. Now, of course, that's in talks. We haven't had anything official and confirmed, but of course, both of them rising stars and definitely something to watch for. Be nice to see this back in production, but we shall have to see. And then Skarsgård is going to move on because the Crow's going to start promotion here, because it's wrapped filming. We got word that it actually wrapped up after a 10-week shoot. So, yeah, lots of stuff moving forward. And we got our final trailer for Halloween Ends, shaping up to be the final confrontation between Laurie Strode and Michael Myers. The trailer, if you've not had a chance to watch it yet, really leans into that final confrontation. Now, of course, the discussion of whether or not Halloween as a franchise continues or stops after this, it's going to continue. It's a horror franchise, folks. That's how this stuff works. And they're aware that that's likely to happen. And if you're a fan of the film Ready or Not, and also Scream 6, where she was in, Samara Weaving has been attached to star in what people are talking about as potential franchise. I don't see that we actually have a studio behind this yet. We have producers and financiers. But the horror film is called AZRAEL. And apparently, it's looking to be what they hope to be, a franchise. So we'll have to see. Evan Katz, who's directed The Haunting of Bly Manor, is going to be directing from the script by the Your Next author, Simon Barrett. Simon Barrett's working on the Godzilla vs. Kong sequel. So they're looking at starting principal photography just right around the corner here in 2 days, on October 10th. So we'll obviously have a lot more information about that. It's no story details at this time, but we'll clearly have those as they are released. And 50 Cent and Eli Roth have turned up. And of course, 50 Cent is Curtis Jackson. And they've teamed up together to have three projects coming out from them. The first is called The Gun, then Trackmaster, and Creature House. Now, The Gun is a young man finds a seeks out to get revenge for his father's murder, finds himself in the possession of a gun that has its own evil issues. Trackmaster is a rap themed horror story where basically two mysterious young rappers get a beat. I'm sorry, they find a mysterious beat. The rappers are just young rappers who find a mysterious beat and insert it in their songs and discover it has side effects of a horrific nature that releases an ancient spirit. They must stop the spirit as well as keep the track from being released, because that's probably a bad thing. And then Creature House is about a special effects guru who passes away, and a group of his friends, and not exactly friends, gather at his studio, only to discover that it's come to life in a horrific manner. Now, we don't have dates on these specifically, but they're going to be produced. Jackson's got his own production company. And of course, they're going to be doing film and television out of this. So I think it's all going to be three film features. But we'll have more news, of course, as we get more news. And M. Night Shyamalan a new film on the way. Knock at the Cabin is coming out in February 3rd of 2023. But he already has, there's already been an announcement that he's going to have another project coming to Universal in April 5th of 2024. No news on that, of course. That's how this works. He very much keeps these stories close to the chest. And we'll have more news as that reports as well. Now, this could drop into the comic section I have a little bit later, but it's a movie, so I'm going to drop it in here. 20th Century Studios has landed the rights to Night of the Ghoul, which is being listed on a lot of news sources as an upcoming graphic novel by Eisner and Harvey winning author Scott Snyder and illustrator Francesco Francavilla. But it's actually a comic that is coming out currently. There's a series. It's an ongoing, or not an ongoing, it's a limited series, but it's currently being released. So you can pick up the individual issues in stores now, should you feel inclined, not wait for the graphic novel release. But the premise here is that a father who is obsessed with a particular period of film and a particular lost film drags his son into a very disturbing and deadly series of events as he tries to track down the hidden story of the mystery of this lost film and discovers that there is something hungry that is not dead. And I've actually read the first two issues of this series, and it's very interesting. And we'll have to see how it turns in adaptation-wise. It could be very much a big-scale creature feature kind of thing. So we'll have to see what happens there. And as I try very hard not to mangle Taisaa Farmiga's name, always mangle some of these names, and my apologies to these folks. She is returning to the Nun series. She's joined the cast of The Nun 2, returning as a character she's played before for the franchise called Sister Irene, where Storm Reed is in this film as well. We announced that a couple of weeks ago. And that's looking to come out in September of 2023. And it's going to be directed by Michael Chavez, who, of course, just did The Conjuring, The Devil Made Me Do It. So we will have more news, of course, as that story information develops. And if you are a fan of Satan's Slaves, Communion, the sequel is coming to Shudder. We talked about this film over on our show, Foreign Bodies, if you ever check that out over on that particular Sci-Fi for Me show. This Shudder has picked up a multi-territory rights for this, and it is the first Indonesian film shot with IMAX technology. So definitely a huge, huge release there. Lots of praise for the film, described as being one of the scariest films to come out in 2021, I think that was. But definitely, we enjoyed it over on Foreign Bodies. And we announced this a couple of weeks ago as well. Paul Greengrass is adapting Stephen King's Fairy Tale, but the discussion was whether or not they were looking for a studio. Well, they now have one. Universal has won the bidding war for the project. Of course, Paul Greengrass is the Jason Bourne films. And he's going to produce the adaptation as well. And the book has just come out, gotten tons of great reviews. So something to look forward to. And it also looks like a return to Stephen King's coming of age stories, where some of this stuff has been set in fantasy and horror settings. Certainly something that a lot of fans have really enjoyed. And we got the news that VHS 99 is coming out on October 20th, a little while back. VHS 85 is on its way as well. It's been announced that it is going to be coming out sometime in 2023, and filming is already underway. The trailer for VHS 99 is out, and if you lived through that time period, boy, they did a remarkably good job of capturing the visual texture, at least in the trailer. We'll have to see how the film holds up. But David Bruckner is going to be involved in this, Scott Derrickson, Gigi Saul Guerrero, Natasha Kermani, and Mike P. Nelson are all going to be involved as directors. And not even at Halloween, but Christmas is on its way, folks, with The Mean One. This would be a horror adaptation of The Grinch. I think some of us remember some other adaptations of The Grinch that could be described as horrors, but David Howard Thornton, who is the star of Art of the Terrifier films, he plays Art the Clown, is going to be playing The Mean One, a hairy green-skinned grump in a Santa suit, living high on a mountain high above the festive small town of Fraser Park. Despising the holiday season, young Cindy You-Know-Who, played by Crystal Martin, whose parents were butchered by the Mean One 20 Christmases earlier, is returning to town to seek closure. No word if there will be songs, which I kind of really want now. Just, I want to hear the horror-themed version of your Mean One, Mr. Grinch. I'm sure they've already thought of that as well. And a film that is one of my personal favorite films of all time. This is and one of the foundational films of horror. If you have never seen The Cabinet of Dr. Caligari, you're missing out, folks. This is coming, finally, we don't have a date yet, but it's coming to 4K. I'm sorry, it's coming to, give it a 12.5. We don't have details on the rest of the release. 4K Ultra HD and limited edition. I'm looking forward to seeing what extras are on this, but it really is one of the great silent films in general, but it also it has influenced so many horror directors and so many science fiction and fantasy directors that if you've not had a chance to see it, I highly recommend it. It is a film that is definitely something that I will own to watch at home, but it is also, if the opportunity comes up, and a lot of art house theaters still do this, to see it on the big screen, I highly, highly recommend it. It is, again, one of the films that just, the impact it's had on horror is very, very hard to describe the level of importance this film has for the genre. And Pennywise, the story of it, is making its way to a collector's edition Blu-ray that is available for pre-order over on Amazon right now. It's coming out November 22nd. Takes viewers, the extras include the book cover, takes viewers back to the original It manuscript and cover design, a deeper look into the music, childhood phobias, where the miniseries cast and crew discuss their own fears, and short interviews and cast and crew, and extended commentary on the legacy. So something to look forward to is going to be the first collector's edition Blu-ray coming from the folks over at Screenbox. And finally, and very last minute, the news from American Horror Story's release date. If you haven't been following this, there are fan sites of American Horror Story that have been I don't follow the fan sites, but they are apparently a big thing in promoting the show, who've been threatening to go on strike because there has not been an actual release date for this new season. Well, the release date has been announced. It's coming out on the 19th. So very, very quickly, this is a very late announcement of a release date for this show. But it's going to start October 19th. It's your first two episodes of the series are going to be released. The name of this series is American Horror Story NYC, so set in New York City, obviously. Zachary Quinto, Sandra Bernhard, Charlie Carver, Joe Montello, Billy Lord, Leslie Grossman, Isaac Powell, Patty LuPone, all returning for this season. There has been a lot of fan demand for this popular and ongoing show, but again, a very, very late announcement on when this is going to be released. And AMC has opened up the writer's room. This is the thing they've been doing, where they've been putting together writer's rooms to help develop series, and then based on what happens in these collaborations, coming together to decide whether or not a show is going to go into production. So far, it's been working out for them pretty well. They have got two new series on the way, one of which is a horror series called The Devil in Silver. This is an adaptation of the novel, and it is potentially going to be an anthology they're looking at. So this first season would be the first installment of this anthology. It tells the story of a character named Pepper, who's a working-class man from Queens who, having a bit of a temper and very bad luck, finds himself committed to a psychiatric hospital, even though he's not insane. He has to deal with other patients, doctors who have their own dark secrets, and quite possibly the devil, who might be lurking behind the silver door at the end of the hall. So definitely the book itself got a lot of very interesting and mostly positive reviews. So we'll have to see what the adaptation looks like. And Interview with the Vampire, getting generally pretty positive reviews at this point, already renewed for a second season. And they have the film, you know, the show just came out. So it was actually announced. And of course, we were off last week, but it was announced before the first season even began to air on the second. The second season is going to be set in Europe and is going to be looking at 8 episodes. And we also got a trailer for the Mayfair Witches. And this, of course, got a release date for this. We originally planned, heard that it was going to be coming out in 2022. A lot of the artwork that had been released in 2022, but now it's going to be January 5th, 2023, exclusively on AMC Plus. And over on The Walking Dead, we now have the word of what the name of the new series spinoff of the many, many spinoffs that we're getting from The Walking Dead, starring Daryl Dixon. Now, this series was originally meant to be Daryl and Carol off in Europe. Melissa McBride is not currently going to be part of the series, taking some time away. But talk that she is going to be joining it later, unconfirmed. The name of the series is Daryl Dixon. There we go. If you're familiar with the show, then you know who the character is. The interesting thing, of course, is that it transplants Daryl to Europe and Paris, specifically over hanging out in France. You can see the Eiffel Tower there. Interesting to see what the rest of the world looks like in the time of the apocalypse. I don't think we actually have release dates for this, but on its way, obviously. And Ryan Murphy, of course, just talked about American Horror Story. Has got a new series, a limited series called The Watcher. It's coming over on Netflix. Now, this is a series that is based on, we know what that means, loosely based on real life events. It stars Naomi Watts and Bobby Cannavale as Maria and Derek Brannick, who move into a house with their kids. Seems lovely. And one day they get a letter welcoming them to the neighborhood from someone who signs himself The Watcher, and more letters come. And they get creepier and creepier, and the neighborhood seems to take on a very dark and ominous feel. Now, this is based on apparently real events where a husband and wife with kids purchased a house. They did not actually move in the real world. They shipped their furniture there. But the letters started to arrive, and they ultimately ended up selling the house at a loss. It's an interesting true life story. Based on the trailer that just came out for this, it's very much leaning into the horror side of things that is not based much in real life. That's all right. Based on when it comes to horror stuff is often a springboard for something newer and creepier. And we got announcements for The Wolfpack and Teen Wolf the movie. There's a new teaser trailer, additional casting released. This, of course, came out through the New York Comic Con stuff coming out from Paramount Plus. So The Wolfpack series is going to premiere January 26, 2023, the same day as Teen Wolf the movie is going to be released. Now, Sarah Michelle Gellar is one of the stars of Wolfpack, and Armani Jackson, Rodrigo Santoro, Bella Shepherd, Bailey Stender, Chase Leafield, Holly Behar, Lonnie June, Rhea Mangini, Stella Smith, Zach Nelson, and James Martinez have all joined the cast as well. And it is an adaptation of the book series Ido Van Belkom wrote, which follows a teenage boy and a teenage girl who get themselves involved with werewolves, hence the name. And over on the comic book side of things, we have got new variant covers. These are just a couple of them that are coming for The Walking Dead Deluxe. This is the color adaptations of the original black and white um, versions of the Walking Dead series. This is the 50th anniversary issue, or sorry, the 50th issue, 50th anniversary. The shows have been on for a long time, but not that long. And so this is going to be available November 2nd, this particular issue. And there's six different variant covers. So something to watch for if you happen to be a fan of the Walking Dead series. And we got news that the Book of Shadows is on its way, coming from the Bram Stoker Award nominated team of Rich Duick and Alex Cormack. This is the third in their series of limited series stories from IDW. This is the Road of Bones, Sea of Sorrows. The third one here is the Book of Shadows. It follows a rock and roll star who has a problem with heroin and just hears that there is a cure to be found somewhere in the jungles of South America, and the demons of drug addiction find themselves being pale in comparisons to the nightmares he finds there. Now, this is set in 1968, and we looks like we are getting a a new series from these folks to coming out in February 2023. And we had had news that Something is Killing the Children, one of the comic series that I regularly pick up, was getting an adaptation over at Netflix from Mike Flanagan and Trevor Macy. And that is not happening anymore. They were co-writing the pilot for the potential series. This is the James Tinian IV and Werther Delan Del Ederas is the illustrator on that. Well, Flanagan says, and he's talking to The Wrap, that this is not going forward. And Netflix apparently is going forward with the project, but not with these guys. So they decided to go a different direction. No other word other than that, a bit disappointing. Or, you know, of course, whether or not this should be happening over at Netflix is up to you, because, of course, it's an ongoing comic series, and Netflix has a tendency to cancel things before they are done, and definitely one to pick up. Now, chalk this one up to maybe, and we'll see. So, Christopher Gans, who's the director of the first Silent Hill film, which, compared to a lot of the projects that have followed, looks pretty good in retrospect, and it had certainly its fans, although it was a very loose adaptation of the original material. He spoke with French website Movie and Game and said that there are something like 4 video game projects in development right now. Now, he said that he has spoken with the folks over at Team Silent and Bloober Team, and apparently they're working on a Silent Hill 2 remake. These other projects going forward. Now, there's been no official news from Konami about any of this. So chalk this up to maybe and possibly, but if it's true, something to look forward to for fans of Silent Hill. And Wordle became a thing. Wordle has been a huge thing. It's still a big thing. Well, now there's one for the horror fans. Hordle. It's an awkward word here, but it is a horror-themed game. Reddit user Gokovici, and I'm not sure who this person is aside from that name, you're presented with 3 frames to guess what the horror movie of the day is. There's a survivor bonus round where you can identify the movie's survivor out of 3 options. Now, this has just launched. It came out on October 1st. And, of course, if you're a fan of trivia games, this looks like it'd be something right up your alley. And apparently, it's only going to run to the end of the month, and then it's going to go away. So we'll see if that actually happens. And a little bit more tech news. Although chilling has actually been around for a little while. They're really making a big push this holiday season. I guess it's going wider. Jamie Kennedy from the Scream franchise is one of the financiers on this. And YouTuber Dane Petrali, and tech unicorn, one of the people who has lots of money who supports this sort of thing, Chris Graham, has got the chilling out. Now, this is meant to be an app to crowdsource, produce, and curate the most chilling horror entertainment content into one app. It's got original stuff on there, Halloween-themed content with categories like blood and gore, psychological thrillers, paranormal horror classics, terrifyingly true, episodics, vintage horror radio. Excuse me. A bunch of fictional content, but there's also some nonfiction stories that can be submitted to the app's Reddit page. It's narrated, the content is narrated by professional voiceover artists, and lots going on here. Now, this came out in originally, its first form in April 2021, picked up 400,000 downloads, 200,000 unique user accounts, and has raised over 129,000 in crowdfunding to date, which is over 500% of what they originally aimed for. So something certainly to look into. I have not done anything with this myself. I can't speak to how good it is, but certainly something to look forward to and explore if you're a horror fan. And Funko has Killer Clowns from Outer Space, a new toy. And this is based on the original poster and VHS art. You're familiar with the Killer Clowns from Outer Space series, you'll recognize this looks a little familiar from the 1988 film. It's going to be available exclusively from Walmart. You can check and see, head over to their website to see what else they might have in this genre. And this one, finally, I'm kind of not sure what to say here. That's right, folks. It's Michael Myers is a Chia Pet. This is a real thing. This is not a manipulated piece of art. This is a real thing. It's the folks from Joseph Enterprises, Inc., the guys, the company that actually makes Chia Pet and the Clapper, have released their new Halloween 2 Michael Myers Chia Pet. Comes with one packet of chia seeds. Yeah. You can pick this up. I'm not sure what. I don't know. It's a thing. Chia pets. All right. Oh. Thank you, folks. Hope you've had a great week. Yeah.
You know what they ought to do? They should take the Michael Myers Chia Pet and put the clapper technology inside it so that when you clap on, the lights, the eyes glow and you hear maybe the theme to Halloween. You know, John Carpenter could get royalty. You hear the music.
Sure.
And then you clap off and it all shuts off.
I think there's definitely potential. If you're going to go with Chia Pet, why not? Just lean all in.
Yeah.
I have to say, when I saw that story, I was like, surely this is it's a real thing. Okay. All right. I mean, why not? I don't understand Chia Pets myself. Never got the point, but.
The Chia Pet Michael Myers would be a perfect decoration for the Vault of the Killer Bees. We should ask, we'll ask.
You know what? I think there'd be some potential there.
Okay.
Good Morning Multiverse, Saturday morning at 11, 10 Central, only on Sci-Fi for Me TV.